I just love getting out here, land-based fishing, particularly when we're targeting like big kingfish.
Yep, we're on. Kingy on.
Get the big kingy.
Shit's going in behind that rock's going under that ledge.
And my favourite, big snapper off the rocks.
Look, here's a biggie, here's a big boy down here.
So in this full feature length episode here on ultimatefishing.tv, it's land-based fishing and we're targeting big kingfish in the summer off the rocks and then in the winter, big snapper. And the normally shy big snapper that you'd be lucky to get a glimpse of at the right time of the year with the right amount of burley, I had this most incredible experience where I could literally hand feed wild snapper.
Come on, eat it, buddy. There you go. Don't bite my hand. Oh, he hit my hand. Oh, I thought he was going to smoke my fingers off, bro.
And of course, as usual, on Ultimate Fishing, we like to give away all of the tips and tricks. So enjoy this full episode. And of course, if you like it, please subscribe because the more you watch, the more I'm going to get out here and make more episodes. Enjoy this one, it's a ripper. It's the Kiwi summer and we've hitched a couple of small boats on the back of the trucks and we're going fishing. But the boats are only going to be used to get us to some of the most remote land-based fishing spots in New Zealand. I can't wait to get on the rocks, but first, I'm going to give my new boat a run and go and stock up on some fresh bait. And we're looking for one of my old favourites, the grey mullet.
Right. First time this boat's ever been in the water. And we're ripping out through the mangroves. That's good. We'll set the fish bin straight on top of it now, please, guys.
Oh, I'll let it bust up.
That'll be king. Yeah, that'll be kingfish chasing mullet. Let's go and have a look at that. It's going to be shallow as hell, but let's go have a look. All the mud there is all dug up, and that is from snapper digging. Middle of the day. What? Waist deep water.
Bright sunshine.
Bright sunshine, yeah. So we've been on the water like 2 minutes, about to set the mullet net, seen some big dog mullets, seen some kingies chasing mullets, and snapper digging in the mud. Yeah, chuck it over the front.
Yeah.
Okay, what we're going to do is bang on the side of the boat. Guys, make a bit of noise, eh?
Mullet can be tricky to catch in these conditions. The sun is bright and the water is clear, so the mullet can see the net and they just swim around it. Unless they're swimming so fast they don't see the net. So we're chasing them around, trying to scare them into the net. This way we don't have to leave the net in the water for hours, where it might get some unwanted bycatch, like juvenile snapper, that also live up here in the harbour shallows. All we want to catch is the mullet.
Those two there, look. They'll be the same two that we saw before. Remember we saw those two big ones boost up here? Targeted them, bro. We sight fished those two. We literally saw two mullet when we're coming out here. Put the net out, we got two. So, can't complain really, eh? Grab that float. Right, coil it in and get it relatively clean as it comes in, fellas. Oh, that's a good mully, boy. That's a good mully. Mate, that's a trophy mullet like that, you don't muck around.
The one that I saw before was four times the size of that. Oh, stop it, mate, come on. Fuck. Trust your old dad, mate. You don't know jack when it comes to mullets.
That's a good one. I love grey mullet. I cut my teeth catching these, commercial fishing for them. And that is a trophy grey mullet if ever I've seen one. And that smell, oh, amazing bait, so good smoked. Now I hope this bad boy's got mullet roe in it. Oh, man, don't worry about me, boys. I'm pumped now. You boys can catch your dirty snappers and kingies tomorrow. I've got my trophy
okay,
right here.
Remember that.
Those other ones are big. Oh, you got another one here. We've got four. Oh, he's had. That's right, the wind will blow us back. Oh, look at that, he was just sitting in there. Oh, and another one, the mullies. I haven't even got any FOMO that I'm not out catching blue marlin at the moment, because I'm catching grey mullets. So this one here, once they go past that gill plate there, so what you do, and then it's like a corkscrew, and you push with this hand, and you go straight through.
beauty.
Just like that, boy.
Mulleting tips with Matt.
Mate, that has given this boat some real mana to start with. Catching some mully. Catching some mullet. It's gonna, you know what I name this boat? Honky. Is this white? It's the first white boat I've ever owned. Already, it's already going over my head, all the different things we could do tomorrow. So, just back to the batch, gear up, rig up. We'll see you in the morning. Beautiful bait, perfect forecast, sun's coming up, and phase one of our plan has begun with these guys.
The Kahawai. We've got Kahawai in the tank for kingfish baits, we've got some big fresh mullet for snapper bait, and we're off to find a spot where we can unload all of our gear onto the rocks. My mate Mike Davis from Hunting and Fishing is along for his first hardcore land-based mission. And my son Shaw, he's done plenty of rock fishing with me. Only this is the first time he's not had to walk all the way into a land-based spot.
Now, land-based fishing, I love it. I truly believe it is the most rewarding way to catch a big snapper or a big kingfish is to do it from the bricks. Now, there's all sorts of people that go land-based fishing because they have to, they don't have a boat. And you might ask, we've got a perfectly good boat here. We've got a fishing machine that we're in. And all we're using it for today is for getting onto those rocks, setting up some burley and bringing the fish to us. When you're land-based fishing, you get to see and experience things you just don't get when you're fishing from the boat. So let's get on the rocks so we can show you what I'm talking about.
So have you done a surgeon's or you've done a back-to-back uni or?
Okay, so the other traces need to be made up.
Pilly, pilly, pilly. Thanks, mate.
All good.
Just gonna whip this pilly on. If you wanna see exactly how I like to rig these up for land-based fishing, you can see the full tip at ultimatefishing.tv. And for how to catch a snapper on one, stay tuned. Been bit. Circle hooks I'm not really striking, just winding. Kahawai, I think. It's alright, we can turn them into bait for the snapper. A nice little one, perfect for a live bait. How, ooh, tell you what, Shaw, grab your little lure, and while these little ones are here, try and catch a couple and get them in the rock pool, please, mate. That doesn't work, Shaw. Oh, yeah, and it does work. Perfect little ones. Unbelievable. Beautiful, well done. I'll get this one in the tank. Perfect, mate, perfect. Get another one, tuck them in the rock pool or something. Bait, bait, bait. Yeah, boy, good boy. The distance the live bait out now is perfect, right? We just gotta find a decent spot. Like, even here, potentially, look. They're sitting there beautiful. Yep, we're on. Kingy on.
Get the big kingy.
Shit's going behind that rock's going under that ledge. Come back out, boy. That's the fish we come for. The old mullet, hey?
Oh, it's a snapper.
Snapper?
On your soft bait?
Yeah.
On the surface?
Yeah.
Yay! That was retrieved on the surface.
Yeah, on the surface.
Okay, mate, that one goes back to Tangaroa. Yeah. First snapper.
Look at that.
Bloody bait boys catching our snapper. Showing me up again with his bloody soft baits. What soft bait's that one?
Huh? That Shimano BioTough one.
Nice. Nice. Can't have him showing me up anymore. Right, get him. Mullet. Nice, nice flapper mullet, me old favourite. And favourite to eat too. And if you want to check out how to eat mullet, where it is beautiful,
other than smoked, check out our poached mullet steaks video. UltimateFishing.tv. If you're doing one of these like big baits, I'll show you how I do them.
Yeah, please.
I don't weave them up and shit, yeah. Particularly with a circle hook. That's it, that's how I'd fish that.
Yeah.
Just let him eat it. Let him eat it. He wants it, let him eat it.
Is that your second bait out of that?
I don't know why. You like half the people that watch the show. They just think I'm having it. They think it's a joke. Use big baits, catch big fish.
No, not at all, mate. I'm there with you.
That's the bait you want to be using, mate. You don't want to be pissing around with small baits at the moment. There's so many kahawa here.
Oh, look at that snapper.
Oh, no, that's a nice snapper there. That's a solid snapper.
Just let him eat that. Let him eat. He'll eat that. He'll eat that. Just let him eat it. You're a bait runner on, eh?
Oh, he's on it.
He's on it. The snapper grabbed it.
Let him eat.
How good's that? We're sight fishing.
Let him eat.
We happy?
Yeah, turn it. Strike him. You got him, Mom. Sight fishing.
Oh, yeah.
No. Just keep it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Never mind. Big bait. Sight fishing, we saw the big snapper just come up and gulp that, swim off, but hook pulled.
Oh.
For me, that's the best bit though. How often you get to, that's what I said coming in here.
Yeah.
You get to see things you do not see from the boat when you fish off the rocks. It was awesome.
Gutted.
Never mind. I was gonna say, but with a big bait like that, the tail, if you were gonna have the hook at the tail end, cut the tail off, because when the hook pulls out the tail,
Right.
It flicks the hook, it won't let the hook roll. So you either chop the tail off or put the hook through the other end.
Okay.
Yep. Anyway, never mind. Now, if there's one thing that is absolutely critical about fishing off the rocks, it's this stuff, burley. When you're here, you can catch your own bait. So if you've got to bring in, if you're limited by the amount of gear you can carry or transport onto the rocks, I would tend to take about 5 times the weight in burley that I would take an actual bait, because once you get that burley out, the kahawai, trevally come around, you can catch them for bait. So you just lob it down there into the wash. It doesn't have to go right out. And that's just, as those waves are coming up, it's cycling out that burley. And on a typical day when there isn't as much wash, you'll actually see the snapper. This time of the year, high to summer, when we're burling, the main thing we're trying to do is get all the bait fish and activity around, which will attract the bigger predators, your big snapper and your kingfish. But in winter, when the fish get really keen to eat, you can literally burly them right up. And if you don't hook them, you can hand feed them. And in fact, while we're waiting for this burly to work, let's go and have a look at the last time. I fished in a spot that I'd never fished in before, just me and a mate. It was around mid-June. In fact, it's the time of the first frost, and it's a time that I look forward to every year. You get about a week period when that water temperature drops about 2 degrees, when we get a cold snap, and it's like a trigger for the snapper to come in close and get a good feed before their metabolism slows right down. And if they can get a good, easy feed and they don't have to chase it like chase a bait fish, they will do things at that time of the year that they will never do at any other time of the year. They lose their shyness, they lose their inhibitions, and well, look at these guys. So this morning we've just taken the dinghy around the rocks to try and burley up some snapper, and so far, so good. Just look at that. That's a big snapper. Yeah, it's looking all right so far.
These snapper have been brought in by the smell of the burley, which we put in the water about 30 minutes ago, along with a steady trail of pilchard chunks. And it took just 10 minutes for us to see the first decent-sized snapper hanging down deep and eating the chunks. But we resisted the urge to drop it a bait with a hook. Instead, we just keep feeding the chunks. So now, these snapper have had a taste, they can smell the burley, and with no apparent danger, they're now out in the open and looking for more food.
Very
guns in. Oh, there he is. Oh, he's all right too, eh?
Can you believe it? Can you believe this? Look. Look at that. I mean, can you believe it? Can you believe it?
Well, I can hardly believe this, and I'm here watching it with my own eyes. The fact is, though, everything we're doing is right. We've not hooked the fish, and we've appealed to their sense of smell and taste right when they are most hungry. And even the flashing light on the camera has become a trigger for these snapper, and they are coming right up to me to check it out.
Oh, stop it.
So we're just continuing to feed these snapper, and they are scoffing anything we throw in the water. Even the steel on the burley pot is getting chomped. This tells me I'm gonna be able to hand feed one of these snapper. I've done it in the past in a different spot, but only at this time of year. But before I hand feed one, just to get them warmed up, I'm gonna see if I can get one of the snapper to pluck a squid off the end of the line.
Now, of course, we could catch those snappers, but a bit of fun.
Come on, boy.
Here he comes.
Here he comes. They both come.
I'm keeping the hook up out of the water, and at the same time, I'm trying to film the action as the snapper comes in and plucks the bait off the hook.
Yeah, here he comes. It's the smaller one.
That's right, I'm upset about hooking a big snapper. It seems crazy, but I just don't want the commotion from this fish to scare the bigger snapper away. And also, in the last half hour, these snapper have kind of become my mates.
Sorry, mate. Far out, you can see right there how they just suck it, inhale their food. I had that tight drag and I was pulling it away and he still got the hook.
We'll try and bring him up gently up here. Should only be hooked in the mouth. Yeah, look, he is. Oh, look at all the squid that he's spewing up.
For its size, this snapper isn't fighting nearly as hard as it could. And I think it's because it's just got used to being on the surface and seeing us. And this has allowed me to guide it quietly around the corner so the other snapper don't get spooked.
I'll bring him around here. There's a nice little spot to land just around here. Hang on, a bit further around, bro. This guy's the smaller one too, eh, bro? Just pick him up carefully, bro, and we'll get a couple of photos and let him go. Grab him by the tail. Cheers, bro. Look at that. Okay, I'm gonna try and get that hook out. Okay, feels like my little mate. Thanks for the awesome morning, bro. You have made my morning, fish.
Boom.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I think because the hook didn't really hurt him, corner of the mouth.
Yeah.
And he was just like, no, I'm just going to stay here. These are my mates.
His mate's still down there.
Is he?
Oh. Yeah.
Did we have a real big one here, eh, bro? I'm like, no more hooks for me. I'm just going to feed these guys.
Oh, here's his mate. Oh, there's a bees are bigger, his mate, eh?
He did another one.
That one behind him is big, eh?
Not bad. Definitely bigger.
He's quite a bit bigger, B. That's the big one. There he is. Right there, look. Oh! 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 Well, look, look, here's a biggie. Here's a big boy down here.
This is incredible. It's ridiculous. I'm face to face with these guys. Look at this one. He's looking at me. That bugger winked at me.
He's gonna bite the camera.
going to bite the camera, bro.
Here he comes.
Here he comes.
I could have touched that guy. I literally could have touched him.
My legs are shaking.
Oh, you can hear him sucking it. Stop it! I could have touched him.
Look at that. That's a nice fish, though. And he's not too shabby either.
Doesn't matter what happens today to me now, bro.
I don't want to catch him now.
I know. It's kind of like they're our mates, eh? Look at him coming from way out there, bro. Look at that. Should I try and hand feed him?
Mate's coming around.
Hang on, mate. I'll give you a squid in a sec if you, so long as you promise not to bite my bloody finger off.
Come on, eat it, buddy. Here you go. Don't bite my hand. Oh, he hit my hand.
Oh, I thought he was going to smoke my fingers off, bro. I dropped nuts and let go.
This is mean.
His mate's coming around.
Don't bite out my hand.
Nice work.
Here he comes, have another bite of that camera.
He don't want to eat the camera anymore, eh? He's tasted it a few times and he's decided it's not food. Got another chunk there, bae. Getting a bit hoha about food.
This rare occurrence of seeing the usually shy snapper out in the open, or even taking food right from your hand, only happens in a small window when the conditions are just right. As soon as I hear on the news that there's snowfall on the desert road in the central North Island, this is my cue to get out on the rocks so I can have experiences like this. And you just don't get this when you're fishing from a boat.
Look at him. Hey buddy, oh, give him a bit of a nudge. I'm patting him. I just patted that snapper. What? This is, I don't know, the footage can't get any more sick than that. Surely we've got to stop.
Here he comes, come on buddy, here you go.
Here you go, bite out my hand. This is, I don't know, the footage can't get any more sick than that. Surely we've got to stop.
Getting the footage is way better than catching the fish. But we can't feed our families on cool footage. And Brandon is hanging out to catch one. Only we can't catch our mates. So we remove the burley, sit down for a while and have some lunch. And once our friendly snapper have moved on, Brandon tosses out a bait and hooks into dinner.
Yeah, I see him. I see him. Well, he's a bit smaller than old mate.
On the Mackie.
Boom. There you go, bro. Nah, that's definitely not one of our mates. Yeah, see, look at the mark on them as well. They were real clean looking fish, those other two.
I'm still keen to catch a snapper, and I don't want to catch one of my mates. So I head around the corner and chuck out a bait. And after about a 10-minute wait, I get my bite.
Oh yeah, look at this. Look at this, bro. Oh, nah. See, when he first caught the light, I thought he was bigger. Look at the colour of him, eh?
You want to grab us a photo for me, bro? I'm just going to let this go.
Stay with him. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy.
So that was a look at how good land-based fishing for snapper is in the middle of winter. But today, it's midsummer. And although we've got a perfectly good boat, all we're using it for today is to access a spot on the rocks, because catching snapper and kingfish is so much more rewarding from the rocks. And the boat allows us to access incredible spots just like this. And when you're fishing from the rocks, you get to see things that you just don't get to see or experience when you're fishing from a boat. And with the right gear, preparation, and know-how, land-based fishing is still incredibly productive.
If you're gonna leave the skin on your car, Hawaii, take the scales off of it.
Now, we really wanna catch a big kingfish off the rocks, which is one of the toughest challenges in all forms of fishing you can have in New Zealand. But while we're waiting for a kingfish to show up, we're keeping ourselves occupied catching a nice feed of snapper.
Little snap.
Good boy, awesome.
We're steadily pulling in snapper from a safe ledge away from the swells, and we're able to be selective with the fish we take. Any fish that are a good eating size or that are legal size and hooked deep, we're keeping them. And the live hooked fish, we have the option to release.
The little one, can go back on the next swell that comes up.
And another good thing about catching these fish is the feeding activity of the snapper and the kahawai, and the commotion of the fish that we're pulling in is helping to send out signals to the larger predators, the big snapper and big kingies.
Waiting to see the big kingie chasing one of these kahawai when we're pulling it in. This live bait was quite happily swimming way out there, and now the live bait's swimming itself up onto the rocks. Now the rocks, quite obviously, aren't a natural habitat of the kahawai. It's swimming in close because it's being chased. So we've got the stick bait because there's obviously a kingie around here that's chased this livey up onto the rocks. There you go. We didn't actually see the fish that chased that kahawai up onto the rocks. Now, you would naturally assume a kingfish, but you can catch snapper on whole kahawai. I have done several times, and if you haven't seen this footage, take a look at this while we're waiting for the kingfish to come back and eat this live bait. I'm going to put on a live kahawai. It might seem crazy using a bait this size for a snapper, but believe me, a big snapper will eat that. We'll see how it goes. Yeah, something's eating the kahawai. Something's eating the kahawai. Might be a kingie. Here he goes. No! Mate. Tell you what, that was a few haircuts ago, wasn't it? But even off the rocks, I've caught big snapper on whole kahawai. Snapper are a true predator. So when you're worried about using anything bigger than a pilli for bait, well, after watching that, that's not enough evidence for you, I don't know. Well, as you swim into the weeds, mate,
No, I'm just trying to get it off. It's a big
kahawai,
I'm just trying to get it off.
Oh, yeah. There's heaps out there, eh?
Tons of them.
How big?
Well, it could be yellowfin.
Out there, right on that tide line. Right on the tide line. Tuna.
Oh, yeah, mate, that's huge shit.
Yep, we're on.
Get off. Let this one go, it's a bit big.
Nah, we'll keep him for dead bait, mate. So, one of the fresh kahawai that we caught just moments ago, even though I'm chopping this up for bait, that is perfectly good to eat. In fact, this young fella just over here, when I used to take him fishing off the rocks, he'd end up eating most of my fillets. Now that there is a big snapper bait, ready to go. Skin off, ready to eat. The trouble is, it's ready to eat for little kahawai muncher over there, and he'd quite often get my fillets in. I'd see the big snapper in the burley, go to chuck my bait out, a little bugger had eaten all my bait. It is good eating. That is good. And the reason we take the skin off is because the tough kahawai skin can just foul up the hooks. So there you go, nice fresh strip of kahawai ready to eat. For the snapper, not for you, sure.
I'll eat it, boy.
I know, I was just saying to the camera before how you'd eat all my baits when we go fishing off the rocks.
Oh, you've got something on already, eh?
Yeah. So it's been picked up. I think it might be a kahawai though, I didn't see it. Kahawai. Jeez. Kahawai. A cannibal kahawai is what it was. I got your lunch, ball bags.
Yeah. I'll eat it, boy.
Tighten up a bit. That'll do.
Pump it.
Pump the wine. Tight. Keep tight. You're going to try and make that step. Get the
monster
high as you can, mate.
Pump.
Get the
monster
high as you can.
Oh, mate, that's awesome. What do you know it? My best fish of the day.
Try to keep his head up. You should have him under control, eh? Watch these swells, we'll just take our time.
Oh, there he is. Oh, you see, he's under the lead.
Kingy.
Oh. It's a kingy, that's alright.
Hey, it looks awesome in that water.
Yeah, well done, mate. Nice way to finish.
Yeah, mate, awesome. That's cool. Awesome.
Well done, mate.
Dude, if you ever look over there, stuff coming out of the water all the time.
How big?
Oh, it could be yellowfin.
Get it all.
Out there, right on that tide line. Right on the tide line. Tuna.
Oh, yeah, mate, that's huge shit.
That was a proper decent rip.
Oh, look at that.
Seriously, I saw a fish about this size come out. They're over a couple of hundred metres, eh?
Now, this morning, before we even hopped off on the rocks, I said, when you're on the rocks, you see things that you just don't otherwise see. Now, I was expecting to see snapper swim up to the surface and take a bait. I was even half expecting to see us catch a nice kingy. I wasn't expecting to see yellowfin jumping out of the water. I mean, we're talking 600-700 metres away, but they don't have to come that much closer, and land-basing one from here could be a reality. Far out.
Big kingy, very big kingy following that up.
Someone pick up my bait rod, I just laid down. Yeah, we're on. Kingy on.
Good man.
Get the big kingy! Get the big kingy!
Live he's been eating. This is what we persevered with it.
Get the big kingy.
Hopefully either that or a shark. Got some big tail beats, whatever it is. I think it is a kingy, eh?
Don't let him get you, boy. Oh, it's kingy.
Kingy. Shit, it's an alright one too.
You want me to get the gas?
Going behind that rock, it's going under that ledge. Come back out, boy. Yes, it's coming back out. Turning him round. Yes, boys. Mike, pull the belly bag in.
Yeah.
He might be hooked deep anyway, so it might be one we're going to take. So he might just gaff him in the shoulder.
Gaff him in the shoulder?
I can't see that hook yet. He's gonna wash up. Grab the leader, hold the leader. Yeah, we're on. Kingy on.
Good man.
Get the big kingy. Get the big kingy.
Shit, it's an all right one too.
Do you want me to get the gaff?
He might be hooked deep anyway, so it might be one we're gonna take. So he might just gaff him in the shoulder.
Gaff him in the shoulder?
I can't see that hook yet. He's gonna wash up. Grab the leader, hold the leader. Put the gaff down and grab him in the mouth. Yeah, just grab him in the mouth. Grab him in the mouth, buddy. You got him?
Got him.
Got him good? Drag him up, buddy. Drag him up, my man.
Nice work, mate.
It's not a bad one, boy.
Not a bad one off the bricks, and like I say, every kilo is worth double, mate. A 15 kilo kingy off the rock's worth a 30 out of the boat. Is he hooked deep, is he? We're gonna take him, eh?
Yeah.
That's the fish we come for. I said, never mind those dirty old snappers. We got plenty of time to catch those here. We'll take him up here, we're gonna bleed him out and get him on ice. Yeah. Thank you. Right, we'll get him cleaned up and get a few picks, eh?
Yeah.
Get a few picks, then we'll get the guts and gills out of him. Get him on that ice that we've got in our Icy Tech. And just soak it up for a bit.
Like me.
Nice kingies like this off the rocks, son. Don't come around that often. Well, not for me anyway, eh? Pretty happy with that. Young fella getting a pick with his old man's kingfish. Fair enough. I suppose you're a bit better looking than me anyway, mate. New hunting and fishing catalogue. Got the big kingy, Abel. The
big kingy!
Mate, look at that. That's a good shot, mate.
Oh, that looks really good.
So it's an important part of the whole process. Obviously, learning how to catch fish is one thing, but then learning how to take care of them is important. So we're going to get the guts and gills out of this straight away. We've got an icy tick up there with ice on it. And, you know, if you can do it properly, it makes a big difference to the flavour, and you're playing the ultimate respect to any fish that you take by eating every bit of it. And when we say every bit, that includes this bit right here, the heart. So there you go, mate. Get into it, still beating. You're not going to get any fresher than that, and I've always been a big one for eating as much of the fish as possible, and it's no stunt. The heart is beautiful, beautiful flesh. Okay, so what we do then now, bud, is we just take this and use the back of the saw part of the knife, just saw through the front of the gills. And when you're doing that, be careful because the blade's pointing up towards you. Okay, so just follow the gills around. And then right at the back of the gill rake, as you can see there.
Yep.
Okay, and then guts and gills all in one piece. Yeah. Ooh. Gonna need a bigger bin. Right, the head's coming off, but it's coming home with us.
The effort that we put into getting out to this rock ledge has given us all an incredible experience. And what's more, we've got a kingfish that we're taking home to process into sashimi, pan-fried fillets, and smoked fish. But let's not forget about the fish we started off catching. I did say mullet are great bait, and I also said they're great eating. So what was our bait today will also be our dinner tonight.
It is my old Pop Cecil's poached mullet steaks, done the old school way. And all I've got to do first is chop the head off, whip the guts out, take the scales off, and then make sure I give the inside of the belly here a good old scrub out. Okay, and now here we have it. Our nice scaleless, gutless, cleaned up fat mullet, and our other ingredients, salt, vinegar, onion. Well, in fact, the way my pop used to do it when he was on the boat is he used to use salt water straight out the sea, but we don't have any of that available now, so we can use fresh water and add salt to it to make salt water. So it's poached, so I've just got a pan here. I don't know about yay, 30 mil of water. Now you don't want it bubbling away furiously, just think poached egg, right? And while that water's coming up to temp, I'm just gonna chop this thing into steaks. There you go, that's what your steak's looking like, through the backbone. Now mullet, people consider it bait, no way. Look at that. I mean, as far as a pretty flesh goes, the mullet flesh is just pearly, and we see it's got a nice little bit of fat in there as well, which is the key to it. You know, you've got to have a fat mullet if you're going to do this recipe. Right, next ingredient, onion. So what we're doing is we're just chucking the onion into the water. So I'm just going to splash a little bit of vinegar in here, and now we're just putting in the main ingredient, of course, the mullet. And that water's not really boiling, it's just sort of just bubbling up. Now that we've chucked that mullet in there, a lot of the heat's gone out, so I've just turned the temperature back up, and we're not going to let that fully boil. We're just going to let that sort of simmer away a little bit. But if you just let it slowly simmer away, it's like all of that rich, juicy oil that lives in that mullet flesh just sits in there and bubbles up inside the flesh, and it sort of poaches in its own delicious flavour, just like it's doing there now. And you can just see it. Pink, pearly flesh is just starting to cook slowly away. And just while we're waiting for that, I'm just going to tidy up. There you go, we're all cleaned up, dishes are done. All we've got to do is now wait for the old mullet to be eaten. It's just been quietly bubbling away for about 10 minutes there, and you can just see all that beautiful yellowy fat coming out of it. Now I don't want to bubble that out too much, so I've turned that right down, and it's time to dish up.
And the beauty of this whole operation is there's only a few ingredients, but you only need one cooking utensil, a bait knife, to do the whole lot. Now when you plate it up, and oh look at that, that's just falling apart in my hands. Now because we've got the scales off of this, we can eat the skin. The side of the fork cut through the skin, so there's no scales on it. Oh my goodness, that is way too good for bait. Come on boys, come and have a taster. You'll never look at mullet the same, ever again. Watch out, there's bones in it, of course. Well, because it's steaks, you know.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Going back for seconds.
Yeah, no, I'm just going
to You've got to have something a little bit more culinary to say. You could have just said it's like real awesome or something. It's good, eh?
Better than bloody dirty old snapper, eh?
It is better than the snapper, eh?
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.